Hi students, and today we are going to discuss another important concept in amines, that is Hofmann ammonolysis. What the reaction? Hofmann ammonolysis. In this method, this is preparation method. Amines preparation. Hofmann bromamide reaction we learn now. Hofmann bromamide degradation. Similarly, Hofmann ammonolysis. The key factors of this reaction we have to discuss first. Basic points. What are the basic points? Alkyl or aryl means alkyl or aryl, that is benzyl, generally benzyl halides. Alkyl or benzyl halides on reaction with we have to react with alcoholic KOH, alcoholic ammonia solution. Alcoholic ammonia solution. Alkyl or benzyl halides on reaction with alcoholic ammonia solution gives respective products, and this is nucleophilic substitution reaction. This is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. Alkyl or benzyl halides on reaction with alcoholic ammonia solution undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. Clear? Then next, in this reaction CX bond cleaved means broke, means have to break, cleaved by ammonia. CX bond is going to be cleaved by ammonia. Clear? And halogen atom is removed. Halogen is displaced. Halogen atom is going to be displaced by NH2 group. Halogen atom displaced by NH2 group. This will be takes place. Alkyl or benzyl halides on reaction with alcoholic ammonia solution is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. In this reaction, CX bond is going to be break by ammonia and halogen atom is substituted by amino group. NH2 group nothing but amino group. This is the conditions. And in this reaction, we have to heat up to 373 Kelvin temperature. Heating 373 Kelvin temperature. This is the condition. But here we are discussing ammonolysis. What is ammonolysis? That we have to discuss. Ammonolysis means what? Very simple. Cleavage of CX bond by NH3. Here I told them CX bond is going to be cleaved by NH3, halogen atom substituted by amino group. Clear? Amino group. And that is where cleavage of CX bond by ammonia by ammonia is called ammonolysis. Let I am taking example. What is ammonolysis? Cleavage of CX bond. Here I am taking R X. R nothing but carbon only. Plus NH3. Look here. You know very well, halogen minus, carbon plus, nitrogen having one lone pair. We have to cleave the bond of CX. This is carbon, alkyl nothing but carbon, by ammonia. So why this is we are breaking means, this is plus na, this ammonia will give lone pair to this carbon, clear? So when ammonia given lone pair to this carbon, this bond is going to be break. So CX bond is going to be break by the ammonia. Now X minus is there, no? When it is donated, nitrogen getting positive charge, immediately this X will attack on nitrogen, clear? So nitrogen given lone pair to R, R will be bonded to N, X will give electron to N, and X will bonded to N. Look here what happened finally. What you are getting? R NH3, clear? Nitrogen given electron plus, and halogen having electron, it will give to nitrogen. X minus. This is ammonolysis. RX bond, that is CX bond, is going to be break due to R by ammonia. So nitrogen will give lone pair to carbon. R and N will bond. Nitrogen getting positive charge. Immediately halogen will give the electrons. So nitrogen and carbon. Carbon means here alkyl group. And this is we are calling ammonium salts. This is we are calling ammonolysis. Ammonolysis takes place by two methods. If you are taking excess RX, you are getting primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary ammonium salts. Alkyl halide you are taking more, primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine, quaternary ammonium salts. If you are taking excess ammonia excess taken, and you are getting only primary amine. This is very important, you have to remember. If you are taking excess alkyl halide, primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary ammonium salt mixture you are getting. If you are taking ammonia excess, you are getting only primary amine. This is 1 degree amine. Let me start first one. Look here, I am taking primary ammonium, clear? So ammonia first I am taking, not primary, only ammonia. Ammonia react with RX. What you are getting? Look here, this bond is going to be break. Then you are getting R. From this one hydrogen react with this halogen, then you are getting HX. One hydrogen, one halogen. HX. Then you are getting RNH2, primary amine. Clear? This is RX alkyl halide. This is ammonia. One hydrogen react with this hydrogen, this halogen, HX you are removing. Then this R will attack on this nitrogen. Clear? RNH2, 1 degree amine. What I told, RX if you are taking more, RX if you are taking more, means excess. One more RX you are taking now. One more RX. Look here. One more hydrogen is going to be react with this halogen. One more HX you are removing. Then R and one more R is there. That is R2NH. This is secondary amine. What we are calling? Secondary amine. Clear? What you are getting? Secondary amine. And this will react with again. This will react with again one more RX. Excess I told na. And then you are getting, one more amine. One more amine. See here, one more hydrogen is there. That will be react with X. Again HX is going to be removed. This time you are getting R3N. What you are getting? R3N. What you are getting? R3N. Next, this one more RX is going to be react. This time, this is plus and this is minus. Clear? And this is minus, this is plus. Go for here, R4 bond N bond X. This is minus, this is plus. Means every time you have to remove one hydrogen, then one R you have to add. So here one hydrogen we removed, one R we added, RNH2. Again, one more hydrogen we removed, one more R is going to be added, alkyl group, R2NH. Again, RX. One more hydrogen we are going to be removed, one more R adding, R3N. And here lone pair is there actually, R nitrogen, lone pair. This lone pair will be done. This lone pair will be done. Clear? R3N. This lone pair, when nitrogen donate, this will get positive charge. This will get positive charge. So this is, look here, this is 1 degree amine and this is 2 degree amine and this is 3 degree amine and this is quaternary ammonium salts. Like this, alkyl halide, if you are taking more, you are getting primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary ammonium salts. Mixture of amines you are getting. Means in this process, you are not capable to get pure amines. By this method, pure amines can't be prepared. Can't be prepared, remember. Because mixture of ammonias you are getting. By this method, means Hofmann ammonolysis is, we have the problem is, pure amines you are not getting, mixture of amines you are getting. If you want to prepare pure amines, that is free amines, then what you have to do means, simple. You have to treat ammonium salt. This I told you here, ammonium salt. You have to treat ammonium salts with strong base. Then you are getting free amines. Look here, I am explaining how free amines you are getting. Free amines. First you have to take ammonium salts, RNH3 plus X minus, with what you have to treat? With strong base. I am taking NaOH. NaOH. Simple. Look here one hydrogen, here OH minus, Na plus and this X will make NaX. Clear? NaX you are getting sodium halide, plus from NH3 one hydrogen will move to here OH, you are getting H2O water molecule. Remaining what we have R, here one hydrogen we removed NH2, like this 1 degree amines you can prepare. So how can we prepare free amines? When ammonium salts is treated with strong base like KOH, NaOH, then free amines you are getting. But by this method you are not getting. Now excess ammonia. If you are taking excess ammonia, clear, that is Rx plus ammonia. Rx plus ammonia. Now this time you have to take excess ammonia. Excess ammonia you are taking, you are getting RnH2, primary amines. Mixture will not get like this. So here the reactivity of alkyl halide. Here we are taking alkyl halide, na? What is the reactivity of alkyl halide? Very important for competitors, you remember. Alkyl halide reactivity we have to remember. Compulsory we have to remember. Ri, alkyl iodide, is more reactive than RBr. RBr is more reactive than RCl. You should not take RF. RF you should not take. Ri is more reactive than RBr. RBr is more reactive than RCl. Simple. Every time we have to remove one hydrogen, in that place one R group, alkyl group, we have to add. Look here, NH3, one hydrogen I removed, that hydrogen react with this X halogen, HX removed, then we have R group, here NH2, primary amine we got. Again one more Rx, again you remove one hydrogen from here, that hydrogen react with this X, HX again removing. R already is there, one more R added, R2NH. NH is there, secondary amine. NH2 is there, primary amine. And next, one more R we are going to be added. So one more hydrogen. Why we are removing here? Always hydrogen means these are acidic hydrogens. This in we have now in ammonia or amines, these are acidic in nature. These are easily can remove. So one more H we are going to be removed by Rx. Again HX we are removing, R3N you are getting. So all three acidic hydrogens completed, but nitrogen having one more lone pair. That lone pair also donated to other compounds. Again Rx react. This hydrogen is not there to replace. Lone pair only it will donate. So you know very well ammonia is a nucleophile. That also you remember. In Hofmann ammonolysis, ammonia act as a nucleophile. Which one act as nucleophile? Ammonia. Why ammonia act as nucleophile means it can donate lone pair. That's why here we discussed it. It is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Clear? That is you are getting finally, this is tertiary amine, only N is there tertiary, NH is there secondary, NH2 is there primary. Now one more R is added, and here we are not substituting anything, we are not removing anything here, all are addition only, finally addition only, nucleophilic here just substituted. We are not removing here. Here we removed HX. Here not removing. Only substitution we are adding. Clear? We are just adding. So R3 is there, one more R, R4, N is there, N, X is added. This is we are calling now quaternary ammonium salts. So mixture you are getting. The demerit of this reaction is we are getting mixture. If you want to pure amines, means by this method you can't prepare. Pure amines you can't prepare by this method. If you want to free amines, then this ammonium salts you have to react with strong base. So ammonium salt when react with the strong base, we are removing sodium halide, water, you are getting primary amines. Next, excess ammonia taken, second condition. If ammonia is taken excess, you are getting primary amines only, mixture of amines you are not getting. Now, alkyl halides we took, reactivity of alkyl halides towards Hofmann ammonolysis. Ra is greater than RBr, RBr is greater than RCl, RF you should not take. This is ammonolysis. Cleavage of CX bond with NH3, NH3 is called ammonolysis. Here ammonia act as nucleophile, that's why we are calling ammonolysis. Remember, in Hofmann ammonolysis, ammonia act as a nucleophile. Clear? If you like this concept, please subscribe to my channel, share with your friends. If you have any difficulty, put a comment, and be safe at home. Thank you.